Welcome to this commencement service for the 2022 class of Columbia Theological Seminary. Last night at the baccalaureate service, Dr. Carvales proclaimed to the graduates, "Thank God you have arrived." Well, we are here this morning to make it official. So, welcome, graduates. Welcome, family and friends, faculty, staff, and trustees. Welcome to this in-person and virtual commencement service. Let us worship God in joy and thanksgiving.
Please rise in body or spirit and join us in the call to worship, which is printed in your order of service.
O Lord, how manifold are your works.
In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
Yonder is the sea, great and wide. Creeping things innumerable are there, living things both small and great.
There go the ships and Leviathan that you formed to sport in it. These all look to you to give them their food in due season.
When you give to them, they gather it up. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things.
When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the ground.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in all God's works.
I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praise to my God while I have being. Praise the Lord.
Thank you. Please join me in the prayer for illumination. I'll be praying in both English and in Twi. Twi is one of the local languages in Ghana. Please shall we pray? Gardener God, you have planted and protected us by your faithful hand. Send us the sap of your grace from Christ, the true vine, and make us blossom and bear the fruits of your love, a sign of your life in us. Let the sweet fragrance of the shoots you have planted give you praise forever. Amen. A reading from Psalm 67. Onyankopon dom yen na shira yen na to wanim chira yen na ma won hu wakwan wo asase so won kwaje amanaman nyina mu onyankopon aman beyi waye aman beyi waye aman eni begye na wato ahosan dwom se wabu aman atentrene na wo chirechire asase so aman kwan Onyankopon aman beyi waye aman nyina beyi waye asase abone duane onyankopon yen nyankopon behira yen onyankopon behira yen na wona wote asase anu nyina asuro no. May God be gracious to us and bless us and give God's face to shine upon us, that your way may be known upon earth, your saving power among all nations. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. Let the nations be glad and sing for joy. For you judge the peoples with equity and guide the nations upon earth. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. The earth has yielded its increase. God, our God, has blessed us. May God continue to bless us. Let all the ends of the earth revere God. Holy wisdom, holy word, thanks be to God.
A reading from Ephesians 1. For this reason, ever since I heard about your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all God's people, I have not stopped giving thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers. I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know God better. I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which you have been called, the riches of this glorious inheritance among God's holy people, and this incomparable great power for us who believe. Holy wisdom, holy word, thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Accept, O Lord, on this commencement morning, our thanks and praise for all that you have done for us. We thank you for the splendor of the whole creation, for the beauty of this world, for the wonder of life and the mystery of love. We thank you for the blessing of family and friends and for the loving care which surrounds us on every side. We thank you for setting us at tasks which demand our best efforts and for leading us to accomplishments which satisfy and delight us. We thank you also for those disappointments and failures that lead us to acknowledge our dependence on you alone. Above all, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, for the truth of his word and the example of his life, for his steadfast obedience, by which he overcame temptation, for his dying, through which he overcame death, and for his rising to life again, in which we are raised to the life of your kingdom. Give us, we pray, an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, a spirit to know and love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. Grant us the gift of your eternal spirit, earth maker, pain bearer, life giver, source of all that is and all that shall be. And may the blessing of God, our Father and Mother, Son and Holy Spirit, be with us now and remain with us forever. Amen.
Please join me, friends, in a prayer of thanksgiving and intercession. The Lord is our God, the Lord is our shepherd. God is a mighty shield from harm, a strong foundation, the creator of life. Lord, you gather together what you love and disperse what is vain. What you bless endures, what you touch thrives. You are our hope, our future, the one who holds our destiny. Lord, we bless this day of celebration and thank you for all you've done to guide us to this place. Thank you for the relationships we've made over these last few years. Thank you for the family and friends who have sustained us and encouraged us when the way ahead seemed hard, when we thought about giving up. Thank you that today is the fruit of hours of preparation and study, reflection and prayer. Thank you for all you've taught through our studies. Help us to remember what we've learned about faithfulness, courage, generosity, and wisdom. Thank you for showing us the resilience we didn't know we had. While we've learned much, we confess that there is pain that we've experienced over these last years too. You know our tender, fragile places. Heal our wounds. Fill us up where we are empty. Forgive us for when we fail to have compassion on those who are burdened. Forgive us for impatience, anger, resentment. This season has been a season of sickness and fear. We remember the fear for our loved ones and the tears for those who have sickened or died. We grieve at the pandemics of sickness, racism, and climate change, the ways that these scourges have ravaged our society. Even as we have been changed by our times, Lord, cultivate in us and among us ministries marked by compassion, courage, and a hunger and thirst for justice. Lord, I ask that you would continue your work in these graduates. Bless them as their futures unfold. Guide them into new work and into communities that will receive them with joy. Let the work of character and intellectual formation continue beyond the classroom. Surround them with people who will encourage them in their service to you and to humanity. Help them to see the best in humanity and its worst too. Help them to see others through your eyes. Let them grow in grace and mercy towards the outsider. Strengthen their ability to stand by the oppressed. Help them to be instruments of righteousness, justice, and peace. Let these who have been entrusted with the gospel work your wonders in the church and the world. Let your holy power that sets the world to right be manifest through them and in their ministries. Lord, you gather together what you love, what you bless endures, what you touch thrives. You are our hope, our future, the one who holds our destiny. Amen.
And now to present a sung blessing to the graduating class of 2022, please welcome Miss Twanetta Taylor.
Of my hand. Honored guests, we are about to begin the ceremony to confer degrees. And in that ceremony, you will see me have the opportunity to place the hood of the regalia around graduates as they, after they are handed their diplomas. This hood marks the graduate's earned degree, and as Dean of Faculty, it is my honor to bestow it on them. This year, I've asked my colleague, Dr. John William Harkins, Senior Lecturer of Pastoral Theology and Care, to take my place for the first degree, the Ph.D. Dr. Harkins is retiring this year after 23 years of distinguished service. I've asked him to do this honor this year because we are celebrating the final graduating class of Columbia's acclaimed Doctor of Theology in Pastoral Counseling, where we have graduates serving as scholars, teachers, and practitioners the world over.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees and upon recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon the following persons the degree of Doctor of Theology with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining.
Matthew Burl Fries. Travis Allen Webster. Joseph Kirk Weitz in absentia.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees and upon recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon the following persons the degree of Doctor of Educational Ministry with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining.
Bertha Bernice Calloway. Vivian Green. Lynn A. Bundy Pabst. Noman Zana Hodge, Mami Sue, Jakutu Malal. Kristen Elizabeth Regal.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees and upon recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon the following persons the degree of Doctor of Ministry with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining.
Richard Henry Brooks in absentia. Victor Chiana, degree awarded at the United Theological College of the West Indies, Kingston, Jamaica. Owain Frater. Nathaniel Bien-Aimé Gracia. Yeah. Thank you. Yes. Johnny Harris Sr. Yes. Paulo Fernando Candido Mendez. Kevin Anthony Page. John Harden Sawyer. Hope Nicole Sims Sutton. You're welcome. Christopher Michael York. Glendon Constantine Young.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees, and upon recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon the following persons the degree of Master of Theology with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining.
Evans Bamenta. We Young Chung. J. Lee Hill, Jr. in absentia. Catherine Suzanne Johnson in absentia. Daniel Lankane Lawson. Noman Jana Hodge, Mommy Sue, Jakutu Malal. Jacqueline L. Turner. Kimberly Omika Scott.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees, and upon recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon the following persons the degree of Master of Divinity with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining.
Gail Scotton Baylor.
Go, Gail.
Marissa Zatazzolo Carver. Martin Thomas Carver. Thanks. Good job. Elisa Shamaria Marshery Castilla. Brittany Madison Daniel. Brandon Lloyd Davis. I got you. John Daniel Debevoise. Karen Wilson Fletcher. Jean Koval Homrighausen. Jason Joseph Howell. Great job. Joseph Philip Jumper. Boom Soo Jung in absentia. Myungjin Kim. Kirsten Dara King. Ashley Margaret Lewis. Tracy F. Lynn. Mary Catherine McAllister. John Edward McCroskey. Samuel Charles Phillips. Amy Renee Remaklis. Candace Erin Rowell. Lauren Catherine Scott. Mylika Michelle Slaughter. Kristen Lynn Sommerfeld. Jinsel Tark. Elliot Lenore Trojanowski.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees and upon the recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon the following persons the degree of Master of Arts in Practical Theology with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining.
Karen Wilson Fletcher. Mung Suan Lian. Mary Catherine McAllister. John Edward McCroskey.
Yes.
Larissa Cajaiba Negreros, in absentia. Amy Renee Remacuas. Lauren Catherine Scott. Mylika Michelle Slaughter. Kristen Lynn Sommerfeld.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees and upon the recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon the following persons the degree of Master of Arts in Theological Studies with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining.
Sylvesta Dunco, in absentia. Hao Xian Suan.
Well, class of 2022, without question, the most important awards are already in your hands, your diplomas from Columbia Theological Seminary. And friends, we honor and celebrate this considerable accomplishment and pray with confidence that God will bless and sustain your ministries and service in the world. As Dean of Faculty and Vice President for Academic Affairs, I'm honored to present the fellowships, awards, and prizes for the class of 2022. For details about each award, please turn to the last three pages of your commencement bulletin. The majority of the academic awards are presented to the graduating class on this occasion. There are some awards that are not given today, including the Floris Wilkes Sanders Prize in Theology and the Presbyterian Women of the Presbytery of St. Andrew Preaching Award. These awards will be presented to returning students at the convocation service at the beginning of the fall 2022 term. So I will introduce each award and announce the recipient or recipients of it. When your name is called, please stand to receive your award. We begin with the fellowships that encourage future study. The recipient of the Harvard A. Anderson Fellowship for Greatest Potential for Future Academic Achievement is Elisa Shamaria Marcherie Castilla. The Columbia Graduate Fellowship is awarded to Catherine Suzanne Johnson, who is an in absentia graduate. The two recipients of the Fannie Jordan Bryan Fellowship are Uyi Yun Chung and Newman Janahaj Mamisu Jakutumalal. The Anna Church Whitner Fellowship is awarded to Alfred Appia. Next, we turn to awards and prizes. The James T. and Celeste M. Boyd Book Fund Award this year goes to four recipients. Marissa Zatazalo Carver. Kirsten Dara King. Samuel Charles Phillips. And Mylika Michelle Slaughter. The recipient of the Robert H. Ramey Christian Fellowship Award for promise of providing outstanding leadership for the church is Kristen Lynn Sommerfeld. The Wilds Book Prize for the highest distinction in academic work during the Master of Divinity degree program goes to Mary Catherine McAllister. The two recipients of the William Dudley Fund Awards for Master of Divinity students who have demonstrated achievement, interest, and commitment in evangelism and church growth are Jean Koval Hamrighausen and John Edward McCroskey. The Abdullah Award for the best paper designing a program for the development of moral and spiritual values goes to Newman Zanahaj Mamisu Jakutumalal. The Julia Abdullah Award for the best paper on the subject, How to Make the Church School Hour the Most Interesting Hour of the Week, goes to Lynn A. Bundy Pabst. The Samuel A. Cartledge New Testament Studies Award, given to the student who prepared the best New Testament exegesis during the academic year, is awarded to Elisa Shamaria Marcherie Castilla. The Emmer Galliard Boyce Memorial Award, given to the student writing the best paper on the creative use of music in worship, goes to John Harden Sawyer. The recipient of the Paul T. Furman Book Prize in Church History for Outstanding Achievement in Church History is Gail Scotton Baylor. This year, the John Nelson Award for the Best Doctor of Ministry or Doctor of Educational Ministry Project that focuses on Scripture and the Missional Church goes to Kristen Elizabeth Regal. The George and Sally Telford Award is presented to the graduating Doctor of Ministry student who shows exceptional ability for congregational leadership with an emphasis on social justice and vision for the church. This year, the award goes to Kevin Anthony Page. The Harold J. Riddle Memorial Book Award is given to the graduating student who has shown highest distinction in the field of pastoral care, particularly in the care of terminally ill patients. This year, the award goes to Amy Renee Ramakas. The Flory S. Johnson Award goes to a graduate who shows promise for excellence in pastoral care to the aging in a parish setting. This year, the recipient is Elliot Lenore Trojanowski. The Indian Town Country Church Award for the student who has done outstanding ministry in a rural congregation goes to Brandon Lloyd Davis. The Lyman and Mickey Mobley Prize in Biblical Scholarship recognizes excellence in biblical studies as it relates to the worship and work of the church. And this year, the recipient is Alfred Appia. This year, Lauren Catherine Scott is the recipient of the William Rivers Waddy Award for Youth Ministry. Our last two awards are cash awards from the Frederick Buechner Center, and they are also accompanied by a handsome memento. The first, the Buechner Award in Preaching, is an award for the master's degree graduating student who has done outstanding work in chapel leadership and preaching courses throughout their entire seminary program. This year, the award goes to Ashley Margaret Lewis. The second award is the Buechner Award in Writing, an award presented to the graduating student from any degree program who exemplifies care and skill in communicating the gospel in written word, in course assignments, and in public and pastoral ministry settings throughout their entire seminary program. This year, the award goes to Candace Erin Rowell. Congratulations to all. This concludes the academic awards for the class of 2022.
It is the long tradition, indeed, it is a bylaw requirement, for the presidents of Columbia Theological Seminary to send out the class of graduates with a charge from the words of Scripture. There are, of course, many charges in the pages of the Bible that range from instructions on ordinary daily activities, what to eat and what to wear, to instructions for shaping healthy communities, what virtues to grow and what vices to weed out. The charge that I have selected for today is, I hope, particularly apt for this year's graduates. We have all been through something these past 2 years, haven't we? We have endured much, both communally and personally. We have had to exercise new muscles of resilience and practice new habits of patience. I have selected a charge that I hope will be a comfort and an encouragement, as well as a command for us as we commit ourselves once again to live as disciples of Jesus and to bear one another's burdens. I cannot imagine a better charge to you than those from the words of Philippians 4. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is anything excellent, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. And here, a prayer of blessing to the graduates. God of grace and glory, assist us in making real and concrete this charge in our lives. In ministry places that burst with abundant life, and in ministry places that are little more than a field of weeds, give us the eyes to see the first stirrings of life in the Spirit, the ears to hear the melody of the Spirit, and the hands and feet to join in your plans and purposes. All these bold prayers we pray in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
congregation receive this parting blessing of God. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ attend you, the love of God surround you, and may the Holy Spirit keep you, so that you may grow in hope and be rooted in faith and flourish in love, both now and forevermore. Amen.